Hey guys, how's it going and welcome back to a different kind of war selection video. Today we are going to be racing to Industrial against a great player, Outlaw Elite. We actually done this a couple of weeks ago, and whilst I was editing the video and getting the replay, they updated the game and I lost the replay. It was my fault because I was just too lazy, and in that game he got to IR in about 22 minutes and rushed me as soon as I hit the Industrial age about 24 minutes in. But anyway, we won't see that, sorry. What you will see is me going Asia and Outlaw going Europe, and we try our very best to get to Industrial first to try and kill the other person. Check out the description for all the info on the monthly giveaways, and get involved in Discord for more fun events like tournaments and lots more coming in the future. I do have some plans coming for the Discord for all you people already in, and I'm just waiting for people to finish the current tournament for country codes and I'll do another one. Enough of that, let's get into the gameplay. So, as you can see, I am trying something a little different with this one. You get to see both sides of Russian. Let me know what you think down below. Anywho, we both start with pretty identical spawns and do pretty much the same thing. Build a house, a warehouse, and then carry on building some houses. For the Stone Age, you'll find with Russian to IR, it's pretty similar for both ages. Rather quickly, the first thing we both build is our temples. I managed to hit Asia first and instantly start upgrading all of my workers, warehouses, and then start building my poultry yard as quick as I can. Outlaw closely follows in behind and gets Europe, upgrades just a selection of workers, and builds his farm instantly. He also upgrades just a few workers on wood. This is most likely because Europe use up a whole load of food for upgrades, whereas Asia workers are only 10 food to upgrade. It's a pretty big difference. At the moment, it's looking pretty similar. With Asia, I tend to move a lot of workers around on different resources when it's needed, although that may be just my playstyle. A bit of time went on, you know, just focusing on resources, making sure we get through the age as quick as possible, and I actually make a few barracks just in case for those pesky animals, so I don't lose any workers going up the ages. I managed to find some water, which is a huge bonus for advancing the age, and I think because of that, the first person to hit medieval was myself. When I got there, instantly I upgrade all my workers and warehouses again, delete some warehouses that are now a little too far out for my workers to get to, and rebuild some more. You want to keep on top of your resources by keeping your warehouses as close to resource as possible, but sometimes with stones and iron rocks, the workers can get stuck, so leave a little gap when placing these. Outlaw looked like he had enough resources to upgrade absolutely everything when he hit medieval, and I had to delete some of my Iron Age barracks to start upgrading to late medieval myself. Shortly after, Outlaw follows with the upgrade too. Whilst upgrading to late medieval, I build an elephant house and a few more barracks. This is so I can instantly upgrade them in industrial. It still looks like Outlaw does not make any sort of attacking units or buildings. Once I hit late medieval, I build just one mountain house for the cannon accuracy upgrade and then start the upgrade to Turkey. I wasn't sure if making these buildings now would save me time later or not, and now Outlaw was on the way to Russia. Of course, it takes a little while to get to industrial, so again, it's just keeping on top of your resources and working out what you will need instantly once upgraded. I was actually first to hit industrial around 23 minutes, and my main concerns were upgrading the barracks, elephant house, and my melting house, just so I can get the units as quick as I can. Not far behind me though was Outlaw, and he managed to upgrade mostly everything in his base, which means I probably had some partisans coming soon. He then built his barracks to start pumping out soldiers, and eventually it turned into a back and forth fight for victory. I thought this was just a rush to IR, but he wanted to destroy me, but I fought back. He actually said GG, so I stopped playing, and then he came back with an army and eventually killed me. It was a very fun game, and that's not my excuse or anything. It was nice to see the difference between Europe and Asia after the most recent update, and it seems pretty balanced to me. Anyway, if you guys enjoyed this type of video, then press the like down below, comment anything at all, or anything I can improve on, and that will put you in the giveaway at the end of the month. More info in the description on that. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and pop those notifications on to not miss out on anything that goes on around here. Get involved in the Discord too, to be notified when my giveaways and fun events go live. Thanks to Outlaw for taking the time to make this video with me. Thanks to you guys for watching, and until next time, peace!